Live from Studio 46, this is CBS 2 News at 9 a.m.
King Charles III has just addressed Parliament in London for the first time as a monarch.
As I stand before you today, I cannot help but feel the weight of history.
This is the biggest celebration of education that New York has ever seen.
Today here at Intrepid, it will be all about helping out one another, just as we did in those days following 9/11.
Cindy Hsu, I'm so excited.
I'm so excited to be here. I'm just like, I'm sitting next to everyone.
What's the big news, Thomas?
The children's show Thomas and Friends is welcoming its first ever autistic character.
Good morning on this Monday, September 12th. Welcome to CBS 2 News at 9 a.m. I'm Cindy Hsu. We have a lot to talk about this morning. Just hours ago, King Charles III addressed both houses of Parliament for the first time since ascending to the throne. And soon, Queen Elizabeth's coffin will travel to St. Giles Cathedral to Edinburgh. Ali Bauman is live in English this morning, and we'll hear from her shortly. Now, this morning, hundreds of students at a school in Brooklyn are making a promise to themselves and their education. We'll take you live to a pep rally for the I Will Graduate program. And then streaming in our 9:30 half hour, could this be the hotel of the future? Why this business may never see an electric bill. Now, before we get to those stories and more, I want to catch up with my dear friend, Elise Finch, with the First Alert forecast. Elise, it was pretty murky out there earlier. Could you feel the humidity? What's the latest?
You can still feel the humidity, Cindy. And let me tell you, that is going to be the case all day long. But if you can tell, yeah, a little bit of blue sky happening. We actually are getting some clearing. Maybe not everywhere, but this is definitely an improvement, right? We had clouds and fog, and now we can actually see a little blue sky, at least in some locations. Still mostly cloudy and foggy in Central Park. We're at 69 degrees, but we are, of course, as you mentioned, looking at the humidity. So for some, it's still kind of soupy and murky out there, but for all, it is humid across the board. Dew points for the most part in the mid and upper 60s and even some low 70s. We consider dew points in the 70s to be oppressive, and that's where we're going to be today. So as soon as you step out the door, you will feel that. Just take a look at the humidity trend. Dew points today right around that 70 degrees, so oppressive level of humidity today. Pretty sticky, still very sticky for tomorrow. It is on Wednesday that we'll watch those dew points drop into the 50s, and that we consider to be comfortable. It'll be even better for Thursday and Friday, but we do have to get through today and again tomorrow. Cindy?
Elise, I know it's supposed to rain again. When will everyone need their umbrellas?
Yeah, so I say, listen, if you're heading out the door right now, bring the umbrella with you, especially if you're going to be out this evening. I would say around 6-7 o'clock, it looks like we could start to see some shower activity. Here's what it looks like right now. So we had early morning shower activity, and some of that was some pretty heavy sales, but you can see the bulk of that heavy rain is offshore, complete with lightning strikes. And so we're getting a little bit of a break, which is why we're seeing some clearing. But then we've got this system, an area of low pressure. You can make out the counterclockwise rotation. We also have a cold front. That's what's pushing into our area. That's going to give us a chance for rain later today. So at 1 o'clock, I mean, there should be at least a number of communities, maybe not all, but certainly quite a few of us that'll be looking at some sunshine at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. But as we head to about 6 or 7, increasing cloud cover. So we'll start to see more of those clouds. We'll see a little bit more of that rain, potentially thunderstorms tonight. And then we'll see some of that activity linger into the overnight hours. And it'll still be kind of unsettled as we head into the first half of your Tuesday. So Tuesday's kind of a day that starts a little dreary, but it should improve. Cindy?
All right. Well, how about the rest of the week? Will the sun be coming back?
Ah, yes, and that is the good news. I said, listen, my friend Cindy Sunshine Hsu is starting her show, so we got to get this together, and we will. High pressure is definitely going to move back in, and right now you can see it's well out west, but it's going to move in. So Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we should be in great shape with plenty of sunshine, and that'll take us right into the weekend, which right now Saturday and Sunday are both looking pretty good. So we just have to wait for it. By midweek, we will have weather worthy of you.
That sounds good, Elise. Thank you. Well, the world is watching Queen Elizabeth's final journey. King Charles has arrived in Scotland after having addressed both houses of Parliament this morning for the first time since becoming king. And unprecedented crowds are expected when public viewings begin tonight for the late Queen. CBS 2's Ali Bauman joins us live from outside Windsor Castle with more on what we can expect. Ali?
Good morning, Cindy. King Charles said that he could feel the weight of history surrounding as he addressed Parliament in London for the first time as king. Trumpets greeted King Charles III and the Queen Consort this morning inside Westminster Hall before the king made a speech for the crowded Houses of Parliament. From London, he went to Scotland, where he's expected to address Parliament in Edinburgh before joining the procession, bringing the Queen's coffin to St. Giles Cathedral in Edinburgh. Here's what the king said earlier this morning.
We gather today in remembrance of the remarkable span of the Queen's dedicated service to her nations and peoples. While very young, Her Late Majesty pledged herself to serve her country and her people, and to maintain the precious principles of constitutional government which lie at the heart of our nation. This vow she kept with unsurpassed devotion.
The Scottish getting an opportunity to be there.
And the Queen will lie at rest in Scotland until tomorrow, when she'll be flown back to London. Cindy?
Allie, what happens next once her coffin arrives in London?
Images just after King Charles III landed.
Right, so after that, then the Queen will lie in state at Westminster for 4 days, and during that time, people will be able to line up and pass by her coffin to pay their respects and say goodbye in person, and it is expected to be extremely crowded, as you can probably imagine, and people are expected to be waiting in line for hours upon hours and even overnight. Cindy?
Now, what happens after the lying in state ends?
The British monarch, where
Well, Cindy, after that, a week from today, there will be the funeral in Westminster, and then the Queen will arrive here in Windsor, where she will be buried in a private ceremony.
All right. Allie Bauman reporting live from outside Windsor Castle. Allie, thank you. Well, an exciting day at schools across the city. Today is Pledge Day for the I Will Graduate program. It's dedicated to empowering students and giving them the tools they need to reach higher education and lead successful lives. And CBS2 is proud to be a part of it under our hashtag Better Together campaign. CBS2's Hannah Klieger joins us live from Brooklyn Collegiate, a College Board school in Brownsville, Brooklyn. Hannah, this is a big step forward for these students.
Cindy, certainly a big step forward. I'm in this classroom right now where the bell just rang. So in just a couple of minutes, these students, along with several hundred others in this school building, but 55,000 across the city, will be making an important pledge to graduate. They're among these students, the 7th through 12th graders that are part of this program called I Will Graduate. And the goal, again, to get them to get focused and stay focused on school. So this pledge signing is going to kick off a 6-week long program incorporated into their daily classes that's going to help them achieve that goal. So obviously that includes support, things like mentorship, tutoring, and you know, just a lot of support for these students to help them stay on that task. So right now I'm here with Tonya Lewis Taylor, right? Yeah. And you are the executive director. Tell us about the importance of these young people signing this pledge.
Yeah, Pledge Day is really about young people making a declaration to themselves, a commitment to themselves to want to be educated and to choose the right path for their lives. And that's really what it's all about. And we're here to undergird them, to help them achieve their dreams. But they absolutely have to make the declaration to be great.
Talk about what happens when this 6-week program begins.
Well, we're excited because the Get Focused, Stay Focused program is really about helping young people develop the tools they need to be successful in school and life. And we have tons of opportunities for them to learn how to develop themselves and how to set goals and how to be focused towards their visions and their dreams. So we're excited about the I Will Graduate Pledge Day and about the Get Focused, Stay Focused curriculum.
When you think about 55,000 students,
55,
that's a big deal. How many schools is that?
We're looking at over 200 schools who have already committed to the I Will Graduate Day pledge, and there's probably about another 70 more that will be part of I Will Graduate Day. So we're excited.
There's a big day on the horizon. Talk about I Will Graduate Day. When, where, what's the big deal all about it?
So I Will Graduate Day is the largest celebration of education. We founded this day 15 years ago. many people know my background. I'm a former executive. I worked at Rockefeller Records with people like Jay-Z and Kanye West, helping to build their careers. And I started a nonprofit organization utilizing the celebrities that came through my office to help us promote a positive message to young people about the importance of staying in school, being focused, and living their dreams.
Amazing. So I will graduate day set scheduled for, at Barclays Center for October 24th. Of course, we'll be checking back in with you live throughout the day. Cindy, back to you.
All right. Hannah Klieger live in Brownsville.
Ooh, you're getting... Yay! All righty. We're going to have more from Pledge Day and the I Will Graduate program throughout the hour, including a preview of a new documentary about what it takes to put all this together. Also, remembering the good that came out of the unimaginable. See how so many are giving back on this 9/11 day of service.
On this day after we mark the tragic events of 9/11, it's a day of service here in New York. And part of the mission is to help end hunger. CBS 2's John Diaz is live at the Intrepid, where volunteers are gathering. And John, how can people get involved?
Good morning, Sydney. Yeah, well, it feels like a big party out here. Plenty of smiling faces, lots of laughter going on out here. And that's really the mission here, is to remember the good days after 9/11 and, you know, carry on that every single year. And that's what's going on right here behind me. You could see plenty of people doing good deeds. Thousands of volunteers throughout the day here coming in here are packing boxes of food for food banks in New York City during what's called 9/11 Day. The day has become the country's largest day of charitable service. Now, coming from all over the tri-state area to lend a helping hand, they're working in two-hour shifts in assembly lines to pack close to 1 million meals. The mission is to mirror what happened following the 9/11 attacks when people united to help families and emergency workers. The co-founder said it was a moment too valuable to waste, and their mission is to recreate it every single year.
We could see what was happening in the country, and it was an amazing phenomenon, nothing like I had ever seen before. People putting aside their differences, focusing in on our common humanity. There was such a sense of unity after 9/11, which of course has dissipated. We live in very divided times now, but we encourage, at least on this one day a year, for people to come together.
Now, just yesterday, loved ones of those who died in 9/11 gathered for the annual reading of the names at the 9/11 Memorial, a somber ceremony that has become a ritual and pays a tribute to all their lives lost. But a live look back out here at the Intrepid. This event is also happening in other major cities across the country. And since it started back in 2016, we are told that they boxed, listen to this, more than 20 million meals. Pretty impressive stuff. We're live this morning from the Intrepid here in Manhattan. West Side, John Diaz, CBS 2 News.
John, it is so impressive to see all those people behind you, you know, giving a helping hand. Thank you so much. All right, up next, a major change happening on Broadway today, the theater that's about to get a new name. And we're going to head back live to a pep rally in Brooklyn where hundreds of students are making a major commitment to themselves and their education. You're watching CBS 2 News at 9 a.m. Welcome back to CBS 2 News at 9 a.m. This is a live look from Brooklyn Collegiate, where Pledge Day for the I Will Graduate program is underway. CBS 2 is a proud partner under our hashtag Better Together campaign. A lot of hard work and passion goes into making I Will Graduate possible. The resilience of the organizers and the students were captured in a documentary.
I Will Graduate Day is a youth empowerment day.
We're pretty much over budget.
We're trying to find an alternative solution.
If we do not find the funding, everything will crash and burn.
Keep pushing yourself, even though it's hard.
The kids who they are right now, I used to be that.
Change the mindset of 5 kids out of 50, and we did our job.
But I'm so grateful to you all, because this is a labor of love.
Now give yourselves a big round of applause!
You can watch the making of I Will Graduate Day 2020 on our streaming service, CBS News New York. It premieres on Monday, October 3rd, with encore performances the weekend of the 22nd and 23rd. And all this is leading up to the I Will Graduate Day at the Barclays Center on Monday, October 24th. We'll be right back. We're just a few minutes away from the season three premiere of The Drew Barrymore Show right here on CBS 2. I got a chance to sit down with her to talk about our shows.
Cindy Hsu, I'm so excited. First of all, I've watched you on the news for a very long time. Is it true that you have been with CBS 2 for 3 decades?
Yes, 29 years. Yeah. Isn't it crazy?
And recently an empty nester?
Yes. My daughter, Rosie, is a sophomore in college, and it's just the two of us. So, and the only thing that's saving me is my dog, honestly. Yep, yep. Thank goodness I have a dog, or else I would be in tears.
So between CBS Mornings, then it's Cindy Hsu, and then it's us.
Yes.
And your approach to news has a really unique intention. Will you tell us about it? Because I really loved it.
It's going to be a show for people who don't love watching the news, because I'm always asking people, you know, who do you watch? And it's like, it's so depressing. And that's why people turn away. So this is going to be, we're going to do the news, but in a totally different light. And we're going to choose different stories. But it's about inspiration. It's about positivity. And when you finish the show and go to Drew, you're already happy.
You know, a lot of what I wanted to do with the news here was talk about the function and the good things that are happening and the good people, because they're out there.
There are so many out there, but we don't hear about, well, we hear about them on your show, Drew Gooders, and, you know, and that's what we love, but there's not enough of it. I'm a huge fan of yours, so I have been watching you forever, and I'm so excited to be here. I'm just like, I'm sitting next to Drew Barrymore.
I'm starstruck by you, because I am the person. Since I was 14 years old and started living on my own, my television is what I left on all the time. Mm. And those were my roommates. They were the white noise. They kept me feeling safe. So I'm really excited to do this with you. It is a true honor. Because I've been watching you on my television for so many years. I'm like, what's up, Cindy Hsu? I know you.
So sweet.
This week, we've got Katy Perry. And I get some good scoop from her. Ooh. I'm not going to lie. I really walked away from that interview going, I can't believe we went to all these places. Idris Elba.
Oh, my gosh.
And his beautiful wife, Sabrina. And it's a new segment called Druber. And so we're driving around. And we just have this great conversation, and we really connected, and that was a dream come true. My ex-boyfriend Justin Long is coming on.
I want to see that one.
Totally. I do too. Well, this is so great. We have lots of work to do, yes. Lots of good stuff to do. Ladies and gentlemen, my
once again, season 3 of The Drew Barrymore Show premieres just a few minutes from now, right here on CBS 2 at 9:30, and she's kicking things off by, what she said, reuniting with her ex-boyfriend, Justin Long.
You got to hug Drew Barrymore.
I did, and jealous. I was so nervous when I went to see her, because sometimes, you know, when you love somebody, you watch on TV,
yes,
or movies, and then you meet them, they're not so nice. She was so nice.
I love
so
it. I'm glad.
Me too. Now, if you want to hang out with me and Elise some more, here's what's happening in our 9:30 half hour. We're going to head back out to Brooklyn Collegiate as hundreds of students make a promise to themselves on this pledge day for a program called I Will Graduate. This is a live look at the pep rally right now. And the beloved children's character Thomas the Tank Engine has an inspiring new friend. All that and more streaming on CBS News New York. And here's how you get there. You can stream it free wherever you are. Just download the CBS News app on any device or smart TV. Hit live and find us on CBS News New York, or watch us on Pluto TV app. We'll be waiting for you on channel 400. If you're sticking around for Drew, thank you so much for joining us.
And if you are switching over to our streaming service, CBS News New York, we will see you in just a few minutes. I'm Elise Finch.
And I'm Cindy Hsu. For all of us here, have a great day.